the 1992 Barcelona opening ceremony. A breathtaking spectacle watched by 2 billion people worldwide. After 40 years of domination, Soviet gymnasts competing as the unified team seized their last chance to prove that their supremacy was a phenomenon unlikely to be seen again. The women's team thwarted the Romanians once again to take the gold medal. In a stunning display, they demonstrated how far women's gymnastics had developed in recent years. No longer merely an exhibition of graceful movement, women's gymnastics had reached new peaks of daring and skill. The overall competition proved to be one of the closest in Olympic history. Eventual winner, Tatiana Gutsu, was lucky to take part at all. Only the injury of teammate Galieva entitled Gutsu entry into the all-around competition. She took the gold medal and became the last unified Soviet women's champion. In Barcelona, the men's unified team continued the Soviet tradition. They beat silver medalists China by more than 5 points. Such a clear margin was due in no small measure to one member of the team, Vitaly Sherbo. The son of a Belarusian artist, 20-year-old Sherbo was the last star of the Soviet school of gymnastics, which had dominated the sport for decades.
It was our last medal as a unified team, but it was also my very first Olympic medal. It was wonderful. But I think it was more amazing to be the overall winner, because the overall gold means that you are a champion forever. There are plenty of ex-world champions, but there are no ex-champions of the Olympic Games.
With a display of technical excellence and imaginative flair, Vitaly Sherbo won 6 out of a possible 8 gold medals. A tally only bettered by American swimmer Mark Spitz, who won 7 golds in Munich in 1972. The breakup of the Soviet Union paved the way for new nations to excel in the gymnastics arena. In Barcelona, Trent Dimas won individual gold on the horizontal bars and became the first American to win gold in a non-boycotted games since 1932. His compatriot Shannon Miller won 4 medals, losing the overall gold to Tatiana Gutsu by the smallest of margins. China became the new nation of innovators. In a games where perfection had seemed unattainable in the judges' eyes, Li Li achieved a maximum 10 on the asymmetric bars to win the gold. Li Xiaoshuang confirmed China's new gymnastic power with a dazzling floor display. 4 years later in Atlanta, Chinese success continued. As Li Xiaoshuang started his last routine on the horizontal bar, the Russian Alexei Nemov held a slim lead for the title of all-around champion. An outstanding performance gave Lee the gold medal and China its first all-around Olympic champion. On the pommel horse, Chinese-born Li Donghua brought his adopted country, Switzerland, its first gymnastics gold medal for 44 years. In the team competition, however, China had to be content with silver. The Russians continued the great Soviet tradition. Outstanding among them was Alexei Nemov, who took three medals in the individual events, including gold in the vault. Ioannis Melissanidis had few hopes of taking any medal home to Greece when he arrived in Atlanta. His floor routine of stunning originality and technical brilliance gave Greece its first gymnastics gold medal since the inaugural games in 1896. In the women's competition, Eastern Europeans dominated, taking 10 of the 18 medals on offer. Lilia Podkopayeva from the Ukraine won gold in the all-around competition and on the floor, and silver on the beam. But nothing could match the drama of the battle between Russia and the USA for the women's team title. After several fine performances on the asymmetric bars, the Americans moved into the gold medal position. Elena Grosheva's dazzling floor exercise brought the Russians back into contention. Dominique Moceanu needed a clean landing in the vault to give the USA victory. America's hopes now rested with Kerry Stroob. On the first jump, she slipped and tore a ligament in her foot. Despite the pain, she made her final attempt. Her bravery and determination had given the American women's team a historic first victory. Through the years, Olympic gymnastics has seen dramatic change and stunning innovation. But one thing has remained constant. Each step on their road to glory has been marked by beauty, power, and grace.